I lost my first eye at the age of 7 months and the second at the age of 13 months due to retinoblastoma, which are retinal tumors. The eyes were removed. The attitude that blind children have toward mobility and toward interacting with the environment will largely reflect the attitudes that people have around them. My parents and my family were very, very respectful of my freedom. Their attitude was that I would grow up to be a productive, contributing adult. So I was raised as a normal child. I was expected and encouraged to run around with other kids, to climb, play tag, to just get out there and be and do what other kids were being and doing. Unfortunately, that is a unique scenario. Most commonly, we see blind kids restricted, limited, conditioned to be dependent on others.
For Daniel Kish, seeing is believing.
He's blind, but that doesn't stop him from riding his bike.
The answer can be found in the clicking sound you hear.
Echolocation is literally a way of seeing with sound. You are illuminating an environment with bursts of energy, and you receive that energy as it reflects from surfaces all around you, and your brain catches and processes those reflections in terms of images. It's really quite similar to the way vision works and to the way light works. The only difference is the energy type. You're using sound instead of light.
Yeah. So there must be places to eat or places to sit along here. That looks like a staircase there. And then we're back to a retaining wall here that just goes up part way with some kind of, maybe those would be trees.
I've been echolocating for as long as I can remember. I didn't even really know I was doing it most of the time. I was actually kind of dragged into sharing this with the rest of the world, kicking and screaming. As I did more and more research into echolocation and how it works and how to teach it, it became more and more and more clear to me the restrictions that blind people are facing, the dependency conditioning that many of them are receiving. So I found my way into the blindness field.
When someone is basically functioning under someone else's supervision, what happens to your brain? Well, you don't have the mechanisms that govern freedom of movement actually operating. Those parts can be reclaimed. We'll learn to produce a sonar signal to gather information from beyond the reach of our cane, from beyond the reach of our arms, our hands, because blindness is really nothing more than a condition that requires adaptation.
Echolocation has already changed my life. I knew years ago when I started losing my vision that I started doing like nervous snapping when I would get somewhere I didn't recognize.
I used to click as a child occasionally, but it was sort of subconscious. When I got older, I kind of did it less because I thought that you're not supposed to do that. That's weird, you know?
I would have to say that Australia is one of the most conservative countries in that area, so we do tend to discourage our children from clicking or making a sound. I have no vision at all. I have no light perception, and I've been this way since I was born. Growing up blind brought its own set of challenges. I would choose to take a guide, so I would choose to hold onto somebody's arm. I didn't feel comfortable really travelling in any other way. I'd get very, very anxious if I had to use a cane by myself. I used to feel very tense and stressed if I had to walk around with a white cane on my own. Lots of blind children will click, will make some kind of audiation, whether it be a finger snap, a hand clap, a thigh slap, whatever it is that they need to do. They know naturally that they need to find out where they are, and they learn very quickly that the world gives off an acoustic signature. Everything has an acoustic signature. But they are discouraged from doing that because it is seen as a socially unacceptable behaviour. I came upon a documentary.
He's blind. Both. So how on earth does Ben do this?
He was clicking. Daniel Kish from World Access for the Blind was called in to work with this boy. I started raising funds to bring him here to work with me. If you can ever imagine that someone had assigned you to go and pick up a rock star from the airport, that's how I felt. And we were walking through the international airport and I was clinging to my friend's elbow and Daniel was just walking so confidently with us. We started walking around my block and to my bus stop and I just started clicking at things and Daniel started talking to me about what echoes I was receiving and very, very quickly I was identifying trees and fences and cars and rubbish bins and all kinds of things very, very quickly on my first day. It was a really exciting, life-changing time.
I worked with her for 7 days. She went from anxiety attacks about leaving her front door alone. By the end of those 7 days, it was getting to the mall on her own and enjoying doing her own shopping.
Since learning echolocation, I now have true choice. I'm not abjectly terrified of traveling independently.
Oh, what is it? Let's go check it out.
Some place new that I've never been before, which is always intriguing and a little bit scary, but not in a bad way, scary in a fun way. Oh, wow. It's a boat. It's got to be a boat. That looks like the front of a boat. Oh, how cool. Something. Go check it out. Oh, it's another boat. Oh, that's interesting, isn't it? I certainly wouldn't have been free and comfortable to enjoy finding out what was around me. I learnt the way somewhere and I learnt the way back. And I gritted my teeth and hoped to God I could do it. If I had been taught this from a very young age, I know that my life would have been different. I know that a lot of my anxiety would have been reduced. If I had had this when I was the age of your children, I imagine that my life now would be very, very different. Letting go of somebody's arm after holding on to it for such a long time, it will be the greatest gift that you give them. Put your blindfolds on and have a little listen by going in and out of the space.
My left eye, I can see what regular people can see at 60 metres, I can see at 1 metre. And in my right eye, what regular people can see at 60 metres, I can see at 3 metres. I've done 2 workshops now with Daniel. And so at each of those sessions, I've learned a little bit more about actually how to click myself, but then how to teach other people.
We can go and explore.
I found an alcove with an alcove in an alcove.
No way. Let's go and find that. Can you show me where that is?
Daniel Kish is certainly an idol. He's been able to bring a systematic teaching method to teach us as professionals how to start people clicking.
It's a tree.
Oh, well done. Great. Fantastic. That's really good. Well done.
Have I ever been more of an explorer around?
Can you find any branches? Can you tell where any branches are?
Yeah, there's one way up there.
Okay.
Hey, you said once we find a tree, that's it.
Yep.
My name is Sean Kendrick, and I'm 10 years old. I'd like to be an artist and sing songs. I'm learning how to do the drums.
We first found out halfway through my pregnancy that he was going to be born blind. Sean never really clicked. He used to always drum and he'd always stamp his feet. You're still actually getting echolocation, but not with the clicking. once Daniel did a workshop and Sean, within second go of trying to click, was clicking the way that Daniel could click.
Wait, where's that camera? So see how my tongue is actually running in, out, in, out, in, out, as I like. It's just some way of helping you, like, locate your way around. Like, it tells us, like, where trees are, benches are. It could even, if you're good, it can even tell you where a ball is. Well, there's a big solid thing.
There is a big solid thing. Okay, and we're just going to go to the right of that solid thing.
As a parent, I've always tried to encourage him to say that, you know, just because you're blind doesn't mean that you're not capable of doing anything that every other person can do, but we just have to find a different way to achieve it.
It's just simply our hope that more and more people hear about the process of echolocation and understand what it really is, then the more it will be valued.
I really do think we are very conservative about the way we treat people with disabilities, because there's a real belief that if it hasn't been done before, you know, it can't be done. It's a real battle.
We've scarcely been 50 years from the point where blind people were routinely institutionalized. I and Julianne were among the first generation of individuals who were even allowed to be fully included in school. I think one of the reasons echolocation is not more common is society isn't ready for it.
I can be out at the shops and people will say to me, who's looking after you? And I'll say, well, I'm 41 years old, so I'm pretty much looking after myself at this point. But there is a real sense of custody and responsibility in Australia. And we're not comfortable with people with various disabilities or involvements being allowed out by themselves.
I'd say the biggest obstacle learning to echolocate is really ourselves. We have to step up to the plate and do it. Others may try to stop us. Others may want to maintain restrictions. It's up to blind individuals to let go of the arm or the helping hand, to step away from borrowing other people's eyes to get us through the day, and learn to see for ourselves. Freedom is not something that is granted or bestowed. Any population that has sought liberty throughout history found it by claiming it, found it by earning it, did not find it because it was given charitably. It was always claimed, and that's something that blind people have to do.